Cochlear implants help people understand speech clearly again, but outdated myths stop thousands from even getting evaluated. I'm going to destroy 6 persistent misconceptions with current medical facts. Whether you are considering cochlear implants, already have one, or know someone who might benefit, you probably encountered confusing information. Many of these myths come from decades ago when the technology was new and less refined, but they are still circulating today when cochlear implants are routine and life-changing. Let's separate outdated fears from modern medical reality. The first myth is you'll wake up hearing perfectly. This expectation creates devastating disappointment. The reality, after surgery, the implant stays off 3 to 4 weeks while you heal. Activation day, the first sounds could be robotic. You could hear beeping like cartoon characters, perhaps. And one patient told me it's like your microwave beeping out a conversation. This isn't a malfunction, it's your brain learning a completely new sound language. Your brain needs 3 to 6 months to adapt. Research shows most people continue improving well beyond 6 months. But here's the tragedy. Some people abandon their journey during this adjustment period because they expected immediate perfection. They quit just when their breakthrough is beginning. But even worse barriers exist. Myth 2 is it's dangerous brain surgery. Here's what's tragic. People choose guaranteed hearing loss over routine outpatient surgery. The reality, small cut behind your ear, threading a wire into the cochlea, the brain tissue itself is never touched, though surgeons work near important structures. Surgery fears aren't the only barriers stopping people. If this is useful, please subscribe for evidence-based hearing content that cuts through misinformation. And I'm curious, what cochlear implant myths have you heard? Whether they are bizarre, outdated, or just plain weird, drop them in the comments. Myth 3 is that the cochlear implant is only for profound deafness. This genuinely frustrates me because qualified people suffer right now believing they don't qualify. Here's what will shock you. If you struggle with speech, even with hearing aids, you might qualify today. Moderate hearing loss now qualifies. Single-sided deafness qualifies. Or speech understanding despite amplification qualifies. Most centres offer free evaluations, yet thousands suffer believing outdated 1980s eligibility myths. But qualified is just the beginning. People need realistic expectations about what implants actually deliver. Myth 4 is that the cochlear implant restores normal hearing. This expectation destroys more success than complications ever could. Here's the analogy that changes everything. Natural hearing conducts a 20,000-piece orchestra with infinite instruments. Cochlear implants, a brilliant 22-piece jazz ensemble. What absolutely stuns people, many get better speech understanding than they ever had with hearing aids. Phone calls return, restaurant conversations become possible. The trade-off, music perception varies wildly. Some find songs different, others discover new appreciation, completely individual experience. Most users tell me excellent speech understanding absolutely justifies the compromise. But realistic expectations aren't enough when age myths create barriers. Myth 5 is too old for cochlear implants. This annoys me because it can rob grandparents of precious family moments. Here's what ageists don't want you knowing. I've witnessed remarkable transformations in people well into their 70s and 80s. Picture this, 79-year-old walks into surgery. 6 months later, she tells me she can finally understand her great-grandchildren again and wishes she'd done it years ago. Her biggest regret, waiting because doctors said too old. Success depends on your motivation, realistic expectations, and basic health for outpatient surgery. Age is irrelevant. Your brain's adaptation doesn't vanish with birthdays. But even when barriers crumble, financial assumptions stop people cold. The final myth, I can't afford cochlear implants. This assumption prevents people from exploring their options. What genuinely concerns me, people suffer years without checking what support is actually available. The shocking truth, many countries provide funding and options exist that people never explore. Most cochlear implant centres have specialists whose entire job is helping navigate funding and payment options. Don't let cost assumptions steal your chance without getting the facts about what's available where you live. Six myths destroyed with current medical reality. If you like this content, please like and subscribe to the channel. And don't forget in the YouTube comments to add any bizarre myths you may have heard. I'll see you in the next video.